Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'll be exploring this power supply from AliExpress named DP100 from ALIENTEK. Check its link on description. I'm excited to tell you that AliExpress Mega Choice Day is going on. Find super deals and discounts on thousands of products with free shipping. Download AliExpress app and apply the codes from the description to get discounts on any items. Let's get started. At first, let's see the basic parameters of this power supply. It has Type-C input, a USB communication port, along with a colorful IPS LCD display. The input is protected for the reverse polarity and under voltage, as well as the output has over voltage, over current, over power, over temperature, and of course, reverse polarity protection. Its maximum output voltage is 30 volt and 5 ampere with maximum of 100 watts of power with the efficiency of up to 97%. Now let's see what we have got inside the box. Wow, it's a hard case carrying bag. Its quality is pretty solid. Here we have the banana plugs made with silicone wire. This cable is for communication with the PC. Also, we have this power connector and a user manual, which I will not read of course, but if you want to have a look at it, then pause the video. Finally, we have the mini power supply. Here is the output socket to connect the given cables, the LCD display for interface, and three buttons for the navigations. One thing that I really like is this scroll wheel. It is very satisfying to just rotate the wheel with my fingers. And here is the Type-C power input with the Type-A USB for output or communication. The whole unit is only 95 grams and the thickness is 16 millimeter, which makes it very much portable. Now for powering the DP100, I can use this type of adapter and connect the given cable to its 5 millimeter DC jack. Or I can use my 65 watt adapter, which has a Type-C PD port. I'll use this cable to power the DP100, which is very straightforward. After the startup logo disappears, we see this interface, which shows the input voltage, setting voltage, setting current, and other things. After the output is turned on, we can see the output voltage, output current, and output power consumption in watt. Now I set the output voltage by pressing the middle button once, then rotate the scroll wheel to bring it to, let's say, 12 volts. Then press the middle button once again to set the current same away, short press the right button to turn on the output. It's a nice thing to notice that there is some LED indication for showing the output is on. And here is the menu for your reference. Now let's test the output voltage with my multimeter. I'm impressed by the accuracy of the power supply. Remember that the output voltage is always a bit lower than the input voltage. I also tested the current output and it seems fine to me. I tested this 4 volt high power LED with 1 ampere constant current and also this small LED with 20 milliampere current. Anyway, this power supply has some other features like using a mouse to control everything and a PC interface to log data as well. Overall, the DP100 digital power supply can be a good choice for any electronics enthusiast as it is lightweight, portable, and versatile. If you want to get one for your electronics adventures, the purchase link will be in the description as well as the code to get a discounted price for your order. See you till my next video.